Oh, hello neighbor. Let me tell you about my day. It has been started since 4:30 this morning. I get up for work at 4:30. Work for 11 and a half, 12 hours. And then I go work an extra detail from 6:30 to 9:30. To make extra money just to pay for my transmission on my truck. And I'm working on another detail tomorrow and Saturday. I don't know why I'm showing you this. It's not like I'm holding up a snake. It's like heavy as a boa constrictor though. You guys better hope I got good editing skills. Because I'm going down to the bare minimum here. Won't be no peeping toms outside. I had a snake delivered today. A lavender albino 100% het pied. I got this snake from Royal Constrictor Designs, Garrick DeMeyer up in Wisconsin. Part of the collection that I purchased had a 100% het pied, possible het lavender female. And if you don't have a male, to compliment both of them, and then that female, in my opinion, that female is kind of wasted. So you need a male that has both of those genes. So I went with 100% visual lavender albino and 100% het pied. The idea is that when you breed lavender albino to a pied, when you have it on both sides, then you make dreamsicles. Anyway, I'm going to go downstairs and I already had my mom open the box because I knew I wasn't going to be home for a long time and I didn't want them sitting in a closed up box all day on the counter or the table. So I had mom open it up just to make sure he was alive and well. And then, of course, when the kids got home from school, they took him out and looked at him. So it's not going to be like a true unboxing video, but we'll go downstairs and take a look. Okay. See in a few minutes. Thanks to the, what do you call it? Movie magic. What was just seconds for you was literally like a minute and a half for me. So much different. Anyway, here we are downstairs. And Garrick has wrote on the lid here that this baby was born 10-2-21, or no, 10-8-21. In a little bit, I will get out, for those of you that don't know the difference between albino and lavender albino, they are not compatible. You can't breed a regular albino to a lavender albino and get a visual albino. You'll create double hets. You'll just have a batch of normals that are both het for, or that all het for both genes, and that is pretty much worthless. So you have to breed a lavender albino to another lavender albino or a het lavender albino in order to produce this. So I will get out a regular albino. Actually, it's one that I just hatched. I didn't do a video of that one. That was an albino het clown bred to a double het albino clown. And we got two eggs, both of them hatched. One of them is a visual albino that is 66% het for clown. What is it with this cat? Every time I do a video, Back up, Sky. Anyway, one's a visual albino that's 66% het for clown, and the other one is a normal that is 100% het albino and 66% het for clown. So let me go get that one and hold them up side by side. And that one also has a paradox. Youper Jason Fitzpatrick was commenting that he's bred snakes for almost 20 years or a little over 20 years and has never created one paradox. And this year I've had two produced. One was a banana heifer, 66% het pied. It had something else in it too, but it had a paradox on its neck. That was pretty cool. And now this albino 66% het clown has a paradox on its face and on its side of its neck. It's pretty cool looking. I mean, it kind of makes it look dirty, but it's just a unique like birthmark to me. It's pretty cool. Anyway, I'll be right back. This guy's a little bit feisty. He likes to strike a little bit. Maybe he'll strike it himself. Okay, so this is the albino that's 66% het for clown. And see the paradox on his side. He's got more on his face. Oh, he is striking at himself. Crazy kid. On that side. He doesn't want to turn. Anyway. So let me get... I'll just get one spot on his back here. And this... Don't you bite me. This version of albino has some orange spots. Like it's mostly yellow and white, but then along the back on the dorsal, there's orange. He's trying to bite me. Okay, so side by side. You can see how much brighter the lavender albino is. I don't know if the camera really picks it up and does it justice, but this one is a little bit dark, like darker yellow. And this one here, the yellows are brighter and the white in between the yellow is almost like a lavender color instead of white. This one's pretty white, and this one, I mean, it looks white in the camera, but in person it looks like it's lavender colored. But anyway, that's the difference. May not be a big difference via the camera, but in person and when breeding, sorry, battery's dying. When breeding, it does make a difference. This lavender het pied bred to another lavender het pied or visual pied or any combination thereof can make what's called a dreamsicle, which is lavender pied. And it's like really, really orange on the dreamsicles. So that's the goal with this guy in a year and a half or so, 2 years. But anyway, that's it for tonight. I'm gonna show you some more. The clutch before it hatched was, ooh, quit striking at me. What are you so jumpy about? He's very jumpy. When I turn the camera on again, I'll show you the banana pied clutch. Those are pretty cool. One of them is already sold. I was gonna keep both of them, but I just realized there's no reason to keep both male visual banana pieds. One will be sufficient so that I can try to produce the total outcome later. But more about that later. All right, bye.